Come join us on our trek down the Natchez Trace Parkway and spend a week with us in Cedar Key, Florida, and then on to the Southeast Adventure Vehicle Expo. The Natchez Trace Parkway is two-lane, 55-mile-an-hour parkway with no stop signs, traffic lights, commercial vehicles, or any road signs advertising anything. Our first stop is Meriwether Lewis Campground, where we will spend 3 nights. This is our camp. We met a lot of fine folks along the way. Here is the location that Meriwether Lewis died, and he is buried here. We found Hole-in-Wald, Tennessee, a quaint little town that we were able to get a late breakfast in. We had several opportunities that we took to drive the old trace. There are sections of about a mile to a mile and a half. Okay, now which way should we go? To see there.
We're used to the Blue Ridge Parkway. Maybe it's pretty in the summer.
You can't see much on trees.
Yeah.
We were spoiled. We traveled the Blue Ridge Parkway last August. And the views here just don't match.
Seems like we're up on a ridge.
We are. We did it on ridges because it's easier to clear, and it doesn't get as soggy.
The road doesn't deteriorate with wash as it would if it was cut into the mountain at lower levels.
Watch your mirror. Yeah, there's
you want to get out and take a photo?
We came across the remnants of an ironworks. Had to stop and take a look. Came across a herd of goats on our way to Tupelo. At the Tupelo Welcome Center, we came across a quilt made of ties. Here we are in Davis Lake Campground, which is an Army Corps of Engineer campground. We had gorgeous sunsets. Our camp was right on the lake. Here you see new friends of ours, Jeff and Rebecca, paddling in their canoe. We crossed the dam on a gravel road and back into the woods. I apologize for the glare on the windshield. We did this gravel road the wrong time of the day. The sun was directly overhead.
drive up here and then let Sophie run.
My only drone flight during the trip. We left Davis Lake Campground and drove to Shell Mound Campground and was greeted by beautiful sunsets that evening. We didn't waste any time. The next day, we were out exploring. There was a special dune they called Shell Mound, which was destroyed by a hurricane recently. While in Cedar Key, we had the opportunity to reconnect with old friends Phil and Laura, who have moved to near Cedar Key. This was our alarm clock every morning as the airboats leave to take the fishermen out. Had the honor of meeting Ed, who resides in this schoolie for 8 years. Arriving at the expo, we found a lot of neat equipment, vehicles, and gear. Here you see the obstacle course they set up so people could gain confidence in their vehicles to be able then to go out into the wilderness. I worked 2 6-hour shifts as a volunteer for my admission and camping. This is the volunteer campground before it was full. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe, as it doesn't cost you anything, but it really helps the channel out.